Hey friends, happy Magic Knight Monday. Welcome back to Magic Knight Rayearth for the Sega Saturn. As usual, we should start out with a little recap here. Let's write in my illustrated diary. And let's read my illustrated diary. Okay, 13 is the new one.
Zagot sent a guy named Ascot to make trouble for us. He came to the village and used his magic to turn Jimny into a huge creature that attacked us. It was terrible. I feel so bad for Sarah. She invested all her love in that pet, and now... Big news today. Really big. One of Zagot's thugs, a fat kid named Ascot, turned Sarah's pet into a massive monster. That's one powerful kid. We were attacked and nearly killed by the thing he made out of Jimny. Definitely not fun.
Sarah's pet was made to grow abnormally large and attack us today. I heard that Zagot had it done by a guy named Ascot. I'm certain Sarah's now beside herself. Poor girl.
There was nothing I could do to save Jimny. Poor Sarah. Now that we've made Sarah sad, I feel just like Kaltus. When he was down, I yelled at him. Now I understand how he felt. I'm a jerk sometimes. My resolution is to try to be more understanding.
The end of this chapter in our adventure was a very painful one. We went to apologize to Sarah for it, but she wouldn't forgive us. I understand how she feels. Kaltus will take care of her until she recovers from the shock. I'm happy for that. At least she has someone.
Alright. Very sad chapter there. But a little bit of character growth from Umi. That's nice to see. I don't see why she had to bring Ascot's weight into it, but maybe if she resolves to be more understanding, she won't say stuff like that in the future. I hope. Well, I think I talked to everyone in Taplon by the Sea that I wanted to talk to. So I called Jiminy a dragon in the last episode. It looked like a dragon to me, but no one else is calling him that, so maybe he's not, I don't know, a dragon-like creature. Maybe a wyvern of some sort, or maybe a wyvern. I can't talk to that person over on the right. I'm just confined to this platform. I wish I could, because maybe she sells the good stuff. Like, I assume that the potions are just a front for some sort of more exciting product that's available. But maybe not. Maybe the potions are all I will ever be able to buy. Alright, let's get Boo back in the lead here. I want her to lead the way in her inner tube. Because if anything happens, she'll be the one most likely to survive because she has a flotation device. The other two are able to swim, but if something happens that makes them no longer able to swim for some reason, Boo will still be afloat. And hopefully she'll be able to recover the situation somehow. You couldn't have. No one could have. Well, maybe I'll come back to Taplon by the Sea in the future and see if there's a happier ending for Sarah. because it'd be kind of a bummer if that's how it ends for her. I just activated the rapid fire function on my controller. I'm not 100% sure where to go now. Oh, is it going to take me... Oh, when the music stayed the same, I thought it might bring me to the world map. Are the vortex is gone? Oh, that's a relief. I'm glad I don't have to deal with that bullshit anymore. Even mashing the button as fast as possible, as my controller is doing for me right now, the swimming speed, still a little unsatisfying. But now that I'm done with this portion of the game, hopefully that's the last of the swimming for a while. Or it will be. Once I get to wherever it is I'm supposed to go. Huh. So I guess the dungeon sunk back into the sea. Well, maybe those guys over to the east are no longer blocking that pier and I can hop up and go wherever the pier takes me. Hey! Would you look at that? Alright, rapid fire deactivate. Me too. Me too. Performance is low today. Ice Village of Rosen. Dang it. Hoping I was done with water. So, those guys were guarding that pier for no reason? Like, I thought it would be attached to some sort of town or village or like house. No, there's nothing between these two locations. Very strange. Alright, Ice Village. Throw a bunch of snow particles on the screen and slow my emulator down even more. Oh, great. Oh, Jesus. Oh, this is verging on intolerable. Let me see if I can do anything to fix this. Give me a sec. Alright, well, I disabled the graphics layer that has the snow on it, which also got rid of the background. Not that there is one here, but hopefully that makes things a little less unbearable. I don't know, still seems bad. Why did I talk to that guy again? The emotional dumps. I know all about the emotional dumps. Ah. Portrait man. I assume I will be talking to you later. Haldina. Haldron? Fire? Guy with a flute, eh? Insert Kool-Aid Man voice here. I'm not going to actually do it. normal thing to say. Oh. So, a path to the Rainbow Junction shop that was not available before. I wonder if I am supposed to have found enough rainbow amulets to afford something by now. The fact that it gives me an actual sign to the Rainbow Junction shop makes me think that maybe I missed some stuff in the water dungeon. But if I did, it's too late to go back now. That's sort of unfortunate. Now, disabling the snow doesn't seem to have affected any of the other graphics that much. But it also didn't help quite as much as I hoped it would. I don't know, I guess it's better. Like, at least the music isn't jittery now. Alright. Another thing to spend my gems on. Wuzuzu! Moonbook, please. Wazaza! Thanks. I want my 5 gems back. So I can hoard them for no reason. Yeah, I don't know why I thought there was more to the currency in the shops than I'm seeing. I guess my memory was skewed. I mean, the gems look very nice. Like, look at that sparkly shiny icon. It looks like it's from Bejeweled. It looks more valuable than it is. H-O-E. Coat? I guess he's pretty fashionable. Okay. Nope. Swipe him? More like swipe right on him. Am I right? Haha. Anachronistic jokes. No, not you. You. That's quite a reference. Oh yeah, it's the Jungle Kid. Uh-oh. Oh, I should have been reading that aloud. I guess that's plot dialogue. Hey, wait a minute now. I have nothing to say to you, pig. Ooh, what was that for? I think it's pretty obvious, Hikaru. Come on, Foo. You're better than acting like this. Oh, you knocked him clear into next week, Foo. I should have knocked him into next year. Yeah, how dare he play a flute and be attractive. You should kill him. Traveling entertainers? You mean the dancer and the flute player? They both came to the village independent of one another. I doubt they're friends. I tell ya, from what I've seen, the guy with the green hair looks pretty tasty. Great. I like it too. It's a hip thing. I want some tea. Ha! Jokes. Oh, it's just piling on the references now. I mean, I guess what else do you say about a countertop? And some tea. Yeah, just bake a cake in this random lady's house that you just barged into. Alright, same bits. Ooh, some books. Can I examine the books? No. Nor the lamp, nor the bed. What about this lamp? Nope. Okay, well, I suppose that's all. Are these drawers? No, that's probably just going to be the same built-in furniture dialogue. What about these, Nope, nothing special. Alright, thanks, lady. I'll see you later. Was there, like, a back door of some sort? No, just a porch. Maybe there was a door underneath the porch. Or I guess that would be a deck. Speaking of deck, this guy just got decked. For being a musician. What is this, a hotel? Wow. Not yet. That might be a plot trigger. And I want to look around a little bit first. Ah. Okay, there's supposed to be water there. I'm just a lowly nomad. Uh-oh. Ah, employees only. Well, that might be a thing later. Can't seem to walk in front of this... the shelving unit. So I guess that's the bar. Anything to say about the fountains? That looked almost like an exit. I like the wind whooshing noises in the music. This music reminds me of the Icicle Inn music in Final Fantasy VII. Why is there no toilet? Whoa! Yeah, just make yourselves a home. Ah, three beds. Three beds for three magic knights. How do you know it's abnormal for this part of Sephiroth? I mean, other than that guy is telling us. That there wasn't this much snow before. I guess that's how she knows. these rooms exactly the same? I think so. No information about the food on that table. Yeah. They at least look exactly the same. Yeah, I don't think disabling the snow layer actually did that much. Nope, nothing down there. Just a deck. Hey, a tube. More towns and villages and cities need tubes. Oh, what have we here? Underground path to Aye village? Iye? Lay with a lowercase L? With an arrow pointing to the left. Alright, Hikaru. Nope, no magic. We're not in the magic using zone. Oh, Hikaru and Umi are having tube trouble. Is this a thing? No. Trouble in Tube Town. Magic Knight Rayearth Mystery. Alright, well, I think that is Rosen Village fully explored. Yeah, I mean, we don't need to stay at an inn to recover. Oh! Never mind. To recover our health, because there's a fountain right there, so it must just be a plot inn. Okay. I can't walk that way. Oh! Or I can. Aww. Nothing to say about this big pile of rocks. That looks suspiciously like an obstacle that can be cleared with an ability. I wonder if that was a glitch and I'm not supposed to be able to get into that cave without the dash ability. I think that's what it's going to end up being. Umi having a little trouble there. Holy crap, who lives here? Nice lamp. Get lamp. Oh, I can't get E-lamp. Observation there. Nice sectional. Can I lounge on this thing? Watch the fireplace. That's what people did for entertainment back before they invented TV. Tube tunnel. I mean, yeah, you can watch someone dance and you can watch someone play flute. There's no moral value to either of those things. They're value neutral. Oh my. Yeah, it must not be too good, otherwise someone would have closed it. I thought they couldn't read Sephiro language. But you have to get a sex joke in there wherever you can. Because you're working designs in the mid to late 90s. That's what they do. Yep. All right, let's catch a few Z's. Let's watch Umi slide around in a panic. I expect some sort of disaster will happen while I'm spending the night. Sneaky music. Oh, she's pipering all of the men into that cave. Now I can use them to help me find the machine that's said to be hidden in this volcano. And when I do, I'll crush it, right along with the pathetic legend of the Magic Knights. I'd have enchanted the village women, too, if that ragged flute player hadn't kept them busy. But not to worry. Once this is over, Flute Boy and the girls are mine anyway. Ha ha ha. Oh, so it's... she's the anti-Pied Piper. Or the guy with the flute is the anti-Pied Piper, I guess. Oh my god! Hikaru! Fu! Wake up! Look! What? What? What's the problem? I have ascertained by looking out this window that all the men are gone. Whoa, what's going on out there? It looks like some kind of meeting is taking place. Something frightening is happening in the village. Ah! Something frightening! Run! Oh, I'm sorry to have startled you. The village men are walking through town in a trance that only seems to occur at night. I probably wouldn't have noticed if I wasn't up late every night doing the books. Well, we're going to get to the bottom of this. Wait a minute, Hikaru. I need my beauty sleep. This isn't our problem. Umi, we can't sit still while these people need our help. Right, Hikaru? Good impression of me, Fu. And you're right. Ugh, looks like I'm outnumbered yet again. I'm going to look 40 before I turn 20 at this rate. Alright. Let's have a little peek at what's going on, and then end the video. East, eh? So many questions. What about these flowers? Nope. No comment. And then this is just a dead end. For no reason. Interesting. a naturally occurring spiky ice ball. That's pretty cool. Oh, it's too dangerous for you to go in here alone. I'm coming with you. Oh, would you? That sounds great. Thanks, Fario. You'll be a great help, I'm sure. Thanks, nothing. More like, no thanks. What was that? Apparently, you've got too many other preoccupations. So I'm saying, no thanks. I'm sure you'd much rather be playing with your little pack of women from earlier anyway. Ah! We're quite capable of taking care of ourselves in there. Isn't that right, Hikaru? Umi? Well, Well, that's how you feel, fine. Do whatever you want, Foo. Foo, have you lost your freaking mind? Oh, Fario was waiting out here for us. I can't believe we just blew him off like that. Oh no. Huh? I've made a terrible mistake. I didn't mean to be so cruel to him. I don't know what's gotten into me. I'll just have to make do. It's alright, Foo. Foo, as soon as we run into Fario again, we'll apologize to him, alright? I hope so. I feel terrible. I really am sorry. Tell you what, I'll say sorry to him too, okay? Oh, would you? Thanks, Hikaru. That means a lot to me. Enough with the I'm okay, you're okay crap. Let's get moving. Oh, Umi. Alright. Tune in tomorrow when the Magic Knights get moving into a mystery cave. See ya.